Catalan radiostation has David Beckham swinging for the fences with one of his first designated player signings at Inter Miami. Barcelona striker Luis Suarez has been offered a rich 4-year deal by the former Real Madrid and Manchester United playmaker, whose club is set to debut in 2020. Recap, France 2-3 US. U20s Suarez will turn 33 during next season, prior to the start of Major League Soccer's campaign. He has scored 25 or more goals in each of his last 7 seasons, the last 5 spent with Barcelona after a 30-31 goal campaigns with Liverpool. Seeing what Zlatan Ibrahimovic is doing with the LA Galaxy shows that aging elite strikers can still terrorize MLS in many other leagues. The Uruguayan has been durable, too, making 40-plus appearances in each of his seasons with Barca. Lihafe una proposta per Maxilani QUEVE, Lautsprecher mit hoher Lautstärke, de moment Suarez no HADITQUE no.
La oferta esta catrana si les cifras, mais que interesantes.
Something new. Speaking to Danish publication Extrabladet at Denmark National Team Camp, midfielder Christian Eriksen stated, with just 1 year remaining on his contract at Spurs, that he could be set for a move away from London this summer. I have the wildest and deepest respect for everything that has happened in Tottenham, it will not be negative, Eriksen told Extrabladet. But I have also said that I would like to try something new. I hope there will be a clarification during the summer. That's the plan. In football you do not know when a clarification comes. It can happen anytime. Everyone wants it best if it happens as soon as possible, but in football things take time. Eriksen, who has appeared more than 200 times for Spurs since joining in 2013, helps the North London side maneuver through nearly 2 seasons playing away from home at Wembley Stadium as well as helping lead Tottenham to the UEFA Champions League final. Losing the creative Danish playmaker would be a big blow to a team with an already small squad, one who wasn't allowed, or able, to make a single signing in each of the last 2 transfer windows. Surely this summer there will be more money to spend on bringing in reinforcements, but it's hard to see Tottenham as successful if Eriksen leaves unless the US has that money to bring. In the next Eriksen from Ajax Donny van de Beek anybody or Eric Lamela finally overcomes his injury problems and becomes the playmaking star he was in Argentina and Italy. What next for Eriksen? Real Madrid are of course looking to improve their squad, and a player of Eriksen's quality will be on the radar of just about all the big stars. Would he accept a move to Manchester United if given a salary rise, even if it means a season back in the Europa League? Would Bayern Munich replace James Place in the squad with Eriksen? It's sure to be an interesting summer ahead. Gianni Infantino will be the FIFA president for at least another 4 years. At the FIFA Congress in France on Wednesday, the Congress re-elected Gianni Infantino to another 4-year presidential term. Infantino was unopposed as his predecessor Sepp Blatter so often was. Gianni Infantino is re-elected as FIFA President until 2023, FIFA Media at FIFA Media, June 5, 2019 under Infantino, FIFA's finances have grown by hundreds of percentage points. According to a report from the AP, last year's Men's World Cup grew FIFA's accounts to $6.40 billion. That means more money dished out to every association and more money to support growing the game or growing executives' bank accounts. As much as Blatter transformed FIFA into a financial behemoth, Infantino seems to be doing so as part of his mandate. He campaigned on the idea in 2015 of increasing the World Cup to 48 teams and has tried to get involved with a 24-team Club World Cup, as FIFA looks to get some of the revenues rolling into UEFA's coffers during the UEFA Champions League. 2019 U20 World Cup U20 World Cup Roundup Quad F Finalists set rank US. U20 S meeting potential head on US. Comes back Stuns favorites France at U20 World Cup Porto, Portugal AP. The inaugural UEFA's Nations League reaches its conclusion this week with the competition's final four in Portugal, when Cristiano Ronaldo will try to lead the hosts to another European title. For England, it's a chance to lift an international trophy for the first time since the 1966 World Cup, while a revamped Netherlands squad in Switzerland will also be fighting for the title. Portugal meets Switzerland in the first semi-final on Wednesday in Porto, while England takes on the Dutch on Thursday in the nearby city of Guimarães in northwestern Portugal. The winners play the final on Sunday in Porto, with the losers meeting in the third-place match in Guimarães. Ronaldo, who led Portugal to its first major title at the 2016 European Championship, took some time off from the national team after its elimination in the round of 16 of the World Cup last summer, but he is back at full strength for the inaugural Nations League at home. He didn't play in any of the team's matches in the competition last year, though he was back for the European qualifiers earlier than this year. We want to win it not only because we are playing at home, but because we want to win titles. Portugal coach Fernando Santos said. And winning the first edition of the Nations League would be great. UEFA launched the Nations League to try to give national teams more meaningful games and reduce the number of friendlies. The creation of yet another UEFA competition attracted a lot of criticism at first, but eventually it produced some exciting games. With a format in which only the group winners advanced, which included relegation between leagues, there were several matches with high stakes involved, especially in the final rounds. England needed a late winner by Harry Kane against World Cup runner-up Croatia to eliminate Spain and seal the team's spot in the final four. More Suarez to MLS, some people were skeptical against the Nations League, especially the clubs. They didn't think this could be an interesting competition, Switzerland coach Vladimir Petkovic said through a translator. But it's the contrary. Every single team in every single league wanted to win. We are happy to be here, and I think in the future we will see that this competition might become even more interesting. The tournament also gave smaller nations a better chance of qualifying for the 2020 European Championship, as all group winners in the four leagues were guaranteed a place in the qualifying playoff. For a team like England, though, the competition is mainly another opportunity to win an official title, something it hasn't done it in more than 5 decades since that World Cup at home. The Englishmen have been on a roll recently, having made it to the semi-finals of the World Cup last year. They followed that up with convincing wins over Spain and Croatia in the Nations League and began the year with a 5-0 route of the Czech Republic and a 5-1 victory over Montenegro in European qualifying. Switzerland is yet to win an international trophy, and the Netherlands hasn't won a title since the 1988 European Championship when current coach Ronald Koeman still played for the national team. The Dutch eliminated World Cup winner France and Germany in its Nations League group. You are playing for a trophy, that's for what Memphis Depay told UEFA's website. That's very important for us. We need to try to get used to winning trophies if we want to be a successful team, because that's what successful teams do. And when you're this close two games away from the prize, then that's a great goal. The Nations League winner will be taking home a prize of 10,5 Millionen Euros, $11.70 million, with 9 Millionen Euros, $10 million, going to the runner-up. More AP Soccer, https://upnews.com/app-soccer/twitter.com/app-sports-tales, also nie on Twitter, https://twitter.com/tasonie, the United States stunning comeback to top le favorites France at the U20 World Cup in Poland was followed up by the battle for the 8 quarter-finalist slot. It took penalty kicks as Mali and Argentina staged a thriller of their own that sat 2-2 after 120 minutes. More Suarez to MLS, about Lady Abi had a wild day, scoring an equalizer in regulation before conceding an own goal in the first minute of extra time and then scoring in penalty kicks as Mali clinched a spot in the final 8. Insanity. So who is going to win this thing, especially with France now out of the mix? Acht Ecuador, by putting them here, we are assuring that La Tricolore will upset the Americans in the next round. 7. South Korea, the only team left from its group, they face a match-up problem with quarterfinal opponent Senegal. 6. Colombia, the wild card of the quarter-finalists. It's difficult to have Farid on Los Cafeteros other than to say it's a win over the hosts on day one, he's laudable. 5. Mali, it may look insane to have Mali solo, given how exciting their matches have been and their taking of France to the wire, but 9 goals allowed in 4 matches isn't promising much. 4. United States, it's just as easy to argue they can win the tournament than it is to say the baby Yanks will bow out against Ecuador. 3. Ukraine, still relatively untested after waxing Panama, but has to sit above the baby Yanks after beating them in the group stage. 2. Senegal, unbeaten with a pair of clean sheets on the record, the Senegalese are in the better part of the bracket when it comes to seeking the title. Italy, vintage tactical Italy has allowed 1 goal through 4 matches while averaging a single goal per game. Next up is a Mali team who shown an ability to be easily opened up by nearly every attack on the schedule. Follow @NicolasMandola, let's block it. Why?